Today I'm going to show you how to make a ginger bug. It's a form of fermented ginger that's perfect for making fizzy fermented beverages that are not only delicious, they're wonderful for gut health. Hi, sweet friends. I'm Mary, and welcome back to Mary's Nest, where I teach traditional cooking skills for making nutrient-dense foods like bone broth, sourdough, ferments, and more. So if you're interested in learning those types of things, consider subscribing to my channel. And don't forget to click on the little notification bell below. That'll let you know every time I upload a new video. Well, a ginger bug is very easy to make, and what we're going to need is 2 heaping tablespoons of grated ginger, 1 tablespoon of sugar, and you just want to use plain white sugar. I've got organic sugar, but even if it's non-organic, that's fine too. The most important thing is that it's just plain white sugar. And then you're just going to need about 2 tablespoons of filtered water. Well, what I'm going to do is just break a piece of ginger off of my larger piece, and I'm going to take a little serrated spoon. This is what they call a grapefruit spoon. And I'm going to use that to just get the skin, the peel, off of the ginger. And once I get all the peel off, I'm going to grate it up to the point where I have two heaping tablespoons full. Well, I've got my ginger peeled, and now I'm going to use one of these microplane graters to grate it to about 2 tablespoons worth. Now, if you don't have one of these, no problem. You can use any kind of grater. And if you don't have a grater, you can just chop this up. Well, I've got about 2 heaping tablespoons of grated ginger here. And if you are grating it on a larger grater as opposed to a microplane grater, or you're chopping it up, you want to have even a little more than that. Now, the next thing you're going to want to do is get a jar about a quart size, and you're going to want to go ahead and put this ginger right into the jar. And then you're going to want to go ahead and add in your 1 tablespoon of white sugar. Now, don't worry about this sugar. The reason that we're adding sugar is this is what's going to help feed the yeast and the good bacteria that's going to help ferment the ginger. And then to that, we're going to want to add in our 2 tablespoons of filtered water. And now, when I say filtered water, what I mean is I want you to add water that doesn't have chlorine in it. So if your local water authority uses chlorine to clean your water, you'll want to pour some out the night before and let it sit out and allow the chlorine to evaporate. Now, I've learned that from some of you that various water districts use chloramides to clean the water, and that those don't easily evaporate. So if you know for a fact that your water authority uses chloramides to clean the water, you may want to use some sort of bottled spring water or something like that, because the chloramides and the chlorine can inhibit the ability for the yeast and the good bacteria to grow, just like when we're doing sourdoughs and other things like that, where we always talk about using filtered water, because the chlorine and these chloramides can inhibit the yeast and bacteria to grow, and so we don't want to do that. We want to encourage the growth. So we'll go ahead now and add in our 2 tablespoons of filtered water. And then we just want to take some kind of wooden spoon, or you know me, I like to use the chopsticks, and just stir it all around just to incorporate the water and the sugar with the ginger, with the grated ginger. And once we get that nicely stirred around and incorporated, we'll go ahead and loosely cover it. Now, I'm just going to go ahead and use a coffee filter. You can certainly use fabric if you want, some clean fabric. And then I'm just going to take a rubber band to secure it. And now what we're going to do next is we've got to work with this for 5 days in order to help the yeast and the good bacteria grow and ferment the ginger. Now, each day for the next 5 days, we're going to remove our covering. We're going to add another 2 tablespoons of grated ginger, another tablespoon of white sugar, and another 2 tablespoons of the filtered water. And we're going to do that for 5 days. And at the end of 5 days, this should be very fizzy and bubbly, and it should smell something along the lines of like yeast or beer, something like that. And you'll know that it's ready to use because it will smell like that, and it'll be all fizzy and bubbly. Then after 5 days, you've got your ginger bug. Now, what do you do with your ginger bug? You can use your ginger bug to make wonderful naturally fermented homemade sodas. You can make ginger ale, a root beer, fizzy teas, pretty much any type of fermented beverage that you'd like to make that you want to be fizzy. And now the next step that you'll do is to get a quart of sweetened liquid, and I will make a follow-up video after 5 days when this is ready, and we'll go through the process of making the homemade fermented beverage, which is basically, thanks to the ginger bug, a fermented soda, and because it's going to become fizzy. And what you'll do is you'll get your quart of sweetened liquid, you'll add a quarter cup of the liquid from the ginger bug, and then you'll take it and decant it into a bottle with a stopper and put it aside to ferment. And after a while, when you go to open it, it'll be a fizzy beverage. So it'll be like a little homemade, naturally fermented fizzy soda. And just a little tip about this ginger bug. When you go to put this aside somewhere in your kitchen to go through the fermentation process over the next 5 days, be sure to put it away from anything else you're fermenting, like maybe your sourdough starter, because you don't want them to sort of cross-contaminate each other. You want the ginger bug to have its own set of yeasts and bacteria, and your sourdough starter to have its own set of yeasts and bacteria. So just sort of put them on opposite ends of your kitchen. Now, if after 5 days you're not ready to use your ginger bug and make a fermented soda, you can just go ahead and put this in your refrigerator. What you'll want to do is you'll just want to take off the coffee filter or the cloth, whatever you're using, and just put on a, you know, plastic lid like this, and then you want to go ahead and put this in your fridge. But like so many fermented things, sourdough starter and so on and so forth, you will want to feed this to keep it going even while it's refrigerated. But once it's refrigerated, you don't need to worry about feeding it every day. You can feed it once a week, and you'll just go through the same process. 2 tablespoons of grated ginger, 1 tablespoon of sugar, white sugar, and 2 tablespoons of filtered water. But for today, I'm going to go ahead and put this in a warm place in my kitchen, and I'm going to feed it, as I explained, over the next 5 days until it's nice and fizzy and smelling very yeasty. And then at that point, I'll come back and I'll make another video to show you what it looks like, so you'll know exactly what yours should be looking like. And then we'll go ahead and make a nice fizzy beverage. If you'd like to learn more about traditional cooking and how to make ferments, be sure to subscribe to my channel and then click on this video over here where I show you how to make beet kvass, another fermented beverage that's wonderful for gut health. And I'll see you over there in my Texas Hill Country kitchen. Love and God bless.